Welcome back, everyone. You can be seated. The next piece you're going to hear has been a labor of love since we started working on this in the summer and planning a really inspiring trip down to Norfolk, Virginia to play at the Little Creek Military Base. And we're re-performing that performance for you this evening. First, I would like to thank Lieutenant Colonel Mike Burgett and the color guard of the Niagara Falls Air Force Reserve Base for being here with us this evening. Junior Louis Mancuso, who is a saxophonist in the symphonic band, for taking care of all of our technical needs this evening. And of course, my partner at the high school in the choral realm, Mrs. Amy Fetterly, for preparing the chorus for this evening's performance. This piece by Stephen Melillo called Beyond Courage is a piece that is dedicated to everyone that has served, is serving, and will serve in the future in the armed forces. In particular, the piece commemorates the Bataan Death March. What you're going to hear is a documentary that has film, musical clips from National Archives, as well as some very interesting ensemble effects. For instance, you will hear six trumpets at one time playing a different bugle call, and they're doing an incredible job with it. And it's not meant to sound together, but you're meant to hear these different calls just sort of blending together as you might on a bass. You're going to hear different areas of absolute cacophony to give you the idea of battle, where things aren't clean and neat and lined up. And you're going to hear a lot of reverence at the very end of the performance. So please enjoy, and thank you for your attendance. And before we do that, if you are a member or a veteran of the Armed Forces, please stand up so we can thank you for your service. People say the younger generations don't understand the sacrifices that were given to have them enjoy the freedoms they do in the United States of America. Good thing for us that every single member on this stage deeply understands that after this entire experience. So I'd like to thank them for all their hard work and dedication working through adversity getting down to Virginia. Thank you so much and enjoy the performance.
Right shoulder. Hump. Thank you.
But like I tell these kids in school, I tell them, I said, a lot of us here, they said, we abuse of that freedom that cost us so much for us to go and fight for and defend, you know, the freedom that we have. And now, I said, now, stealing each other, killing each other, roughing somebody as they play and this and that. I said, that's not the kind of freedom that we went to fight for. The same with the flag, you know, some fellows burn the flag, some of them wear their flag on the rear end. I said, you don't know the value of that flag. Respect that flag, because to me, next to God and religion, the next one is a flag of the United States of America. And I still have a lot of respect for that flag, and I'll have respect till the day that I die.
Thank you. The attack also was made on all naval and military activities on the principal island of Oahu.
Talk of peace and of friendship. We've found out just what all that talk was worth. All right, they've asked for it, and now they're going to get it. We'll blow every one of them right off of the face of the earth.
Remember Pearl Harbor, in the air, on the land, on the sea. Remember Pearl Harbor, here's a job we can do, you and me. Keep them flying high, clear across the pond. Make our dollars fight, buy another bond.
Where angels fear to tread, and so I come to you, my. summer. I am really low down. They are around now, smashing rifles. They bring in the wounded every minute. It is a horrible sight. We will be waiting for you guys to help. This is the only thing I get that can be done. Everyone is falling like a baby.
Conductor, 2番、5番、5番走行と補助する。 think that the best way to escape war is to dwell upon it forever, and to imprint them vividly upon the minds of the younger generation. They flaunt the grisly photographs before their eyes. They fill their ears with tales of carnage. They dilate upon the ineptitude of generals and men. Now all this teaching ought to be very useful in preventing us from attacking or invading any other country. But how would it help us if we were attacked or invaded ourselves? Would the invaders consent to visit Lord Beaverbrook's exhibition? Or listen to the impassioned appeals of Mr. Lloyd George, who are being taught from childhood to think of war as a glorious exercise, and death in battle as the noblest fate for man? There is a nation in the grip of a group of ruthless men preaching a gospel of intolerance and racial pride. In that country, all pacifist speeches, all morbid war books are forbidden or suppressed, and their authors rigorously imprisoned. From their new table of commandments, they have omitted, "Thou shalt not kill women and children, the weak and frail, the pacifist and the jingo, the warrior and the civilian, the frontline trenches and the cottage home. All lie in equal and impartial territory." Or rather, has come back the most brutish member and barbarism, namely the possibility of compelling the submission of races by terrorizing and torturing their civil population. And worst of all, the more civilized the country is, the larger and more splendid its cities, the more intricate the structure of its social and economic life, the more is it vulnerable, the more is it at the mercy of those who may make it their prey.
Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, direct to you live at 0 hour from the Rainbow Room at the Rockefeller Center, and sent out to all our boys in the Pacific, please welcome Mrs. Nina Bañegas.
Thank you. sincere and faithful men and women who are asking themselves this Christmas, how can we light our tree? How can we give our gift? How can we meet and worship with love, with uplifted spirit and heart, that a world at war, a world fighting and suffering and death,
from somewhere on the South Pacific. We present the Bob Hope Show. right, always to be good. Right now. Thank you.